Hey, Matty Fash, it's the 3rd of October 2019, and this video has to go into the you gotta be kidding me category. I'm not sure exactly what it means, but I'll tell you what, this is pretty doggone crazy. We had this World War II bomber crash yesterday in Connecticut, right? Now there's 7 dead and 7 injured. Well, this exact same airplane literally flew right over my house last week on its way to an air show in Maine, because that's where this plane tours, right? Tours all over Connecticut, Maine, New Hampshire, and Massachusetts. The plane lives in Massachusetts, right? This exact plane that crashed yesterday flew directly over my house 7 days prior to the crash. And my neighbor, Steve, he's like 72 years old, and he knows all about these planes. This B-17 comes flying directly over my house, pretty low, and we're looking at it, and I'm like, what kind of plane is that? And Steve was like, that is a B-17. He knew all about this thing. Steven, good old Steve, he's a non-believer, but I'm working on him, and I'm probably going to show him this video. So we saw that on the 25th. It was last Wednesday. And then this crash happens yesterday, 7 days later. 7 people died and 7 injured. It's just, this is one of the craziest things that's ever occurred to me, you guys. It gets even weirder than this. Okay, it's a B-17G. And the crash had 3 crew, 10 passengers, 13 people in all. And it was known as a Flying Fortress. And the name of the plane was 909. And it was originally part of the 323rd Bomb Squadron, the 91st Bomb Group, as in like my fortress, Psalm 91. And it was made at the Long Beach facility. Okay? And it literally went into service on the 7th of April, 1945. Now, this is where it gets absolutely crazy. Long Beach is a area where I was led over 2 years ago, and God has never let it get away from me. When this image was posted on Drudge Report on the 6th of April, 2017, and I knew that it was something, and this image is absolutely demonic to the core, and it's got a king in it. And incidentally, it comes with its own demons. And don't forget, when they come out of the pit, they had a king over them. And there's your king. No joke, folks. They had a king over them. Revelation 9:11. Demons flying at you. I mean, this is just downright evil. Drudge Report, April 6th, 2017. All right? The plane was put in service April 7th, 1945. But get a load of this. The 909, which was the name of the plane. You got to just see all this stuff, you guys. I got to show you as much as I can because this is out of control. The 909 was the vintage plane that crashed Wednesday while flying into the airport, right? The 909, yesterday, the 2nd of October. The nuclear image off of Long Beach, because that is where this image is, Long Beach with the oil rigs. If you were looking off of Long Beach or Huntington Beach, you'd be looking out at this nuke going off the coast. And that's just something that's been with me ever since that day. And it was 909 days exactly from the day I saw the image on Drudge to the day of the crash. 909, and the name of the plane is 909. And as of tomorrow, the 4th, it'll be 911 days. The plane was built at Long Beach. The nuke is at Long Beach. It went into service on the 7th of April. I saw the nuke on the 6th of April. There was only 3,000 of them produced there, and only 23 survive. You gotta look at this stuff. It's insane, you guys. This is the plane right here, destroyed and crash and landing. The blah blah blah, the 909. believable. And this is how many were made. There was only three plants that made them. Long Beach made 3,000 of them. Only 23 survive out of 46. There's only 46 total. This is just off the charts, you guys. I'm sorry, but to me, this is like huge. But this seems to be an immediacy thing in my spirit. That's why I'm sharing it with you right now. No holds barred. You know what I mean? I just have to show you that. From that nuke image off of Long Beach, California, to the crash of the 909 Flying Fortress was 909 days. Tomorrow it'll be 911. It's just something that I have to do. You know what I'm saying? I don't know exactly what it means, but I can tell you it means something. And I know, and I've known since the day this was shown to me here, that this is gonna happen. I don't know if it, you know, North Korea nukes, Russian, China, whatever. But I'm telling you, this country is about to experience something it never has before, and people are not gonna be able to handle it. And they're just gonna do whatever they're told, like literal sheep to the slaughter. So I pray that you know Jesus Christ. If you don't, you better drop to your knees and sincerely, humbly, knowing you need a Savior, ask Him to show you the truth. Call on the name of Jesus. So, heads up. Peace and grace to y'all. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,